Hi, so I'm here and I'm making a video, and what I would like to attempt to do in this video is demonstrate uploading a P5 sketch from your laptop to a server so that other people could go to their own web browsers, type in some URL, and see the marvelous, wonderful work that you've done. So before I go to the computer and demonstrate the steps, what I would like to do is discuss all the different pieces at play here. And this is actually kind of a simple thing in a way. I think I'm probably going to overcomplicate it, but let's give this a try. You could just shut this off or speed ahead like 5 minutes if you just want to get to the guts here. Okay, so what's happening? You are working on a laptop, and you have the P5 IDE. You're working in the P5 IDE, which if we zoom in on that, you're writing some code. And that code is JavaScript. You're writing code in JavaScript. There's a play button somewhere in that IDE, and you hit play. And when you hit play, you see another window open up. That window is actually a browser window, and you'll see the result of your code. Whatever you've written in your code, draw a circle, draw a rectangle, all that stuff, it's there in this browser. So all of this is happening just locally on your laptop. Here's the thing that you might not consider or have thought of. There's in that step, when you hit play, what happens? Launch a server. There's actually a server that's running on your machine, your laptop. I don't know why. I'm assuming you're using a laptop, but that's what I'm using these days, so maybe you are too. But that server is launched behind the scenes, which serves up your sketch and allows this little browser window to see it. And so what we want to do is we want to find another server, one that's not sitting on your laptop, but that's actually out in the internet, you know, the cloud. I think I said this in a different video, but it's definitely, there's no cloud. It's an underground bunker somewhere. But a server somewhere that other people could connect to, lots of other laptops, they could connect to through some URL. And they could see your beautiful circles and squares on their screen. Because you don't really, it's not really realistic at this point for your laptop, for this little server to suddenly serve out to the world and have everybody connect to you. Although, you know, this is possible, but that's another story for another day. So what you need to do is take this code and put it on that server and figure out what that URL is, and then everyone else will be able to see your beautiful circles and squares that you spent, you know, so much time thinking about where to put them, what colors they should be, and purple and blue, I don't know, the colors of the rainbow. It's a nice thing to think about. So this is the steps that we want to do. Now, here's another piece. You were writing, we said, JavaScript code here. So you'd think, like, all I need to do is take my JavaScript code and put that on the server. But what's happening in this P5 IDE is, in addition to the JavaScript code, which might be called, there might be a file called something like sketch.js, that's where your code is sitting. Behind the scenes, and you'll, in some other video, or somebody else will talk to you, or I don't know when, but I'm not gonna get into this too much right now in this moment, there is another file called index.html. And when these requests are made, this is really the file. This is the core file that gets sent back from the server that gets loaded into the browser. And this file refers to your JavaScript code. So in turn, your JavaScript code is seen in the browser. But so these are the two files. And there's other files. You might have, you know, images and sound files. And there's something called CSS, which will add some styling and layout and different things. But ultimately, you need at least these two files. I forgot something. Okay, but you need these two files and you need to send them to the server. Okay, what did I forget? There's also going to be a folder called lib. And that folder called lib is going to have other things in it, like a file called p5.js. That's the P5 library. You know, there's a longer story here of, okay, well, you don't actually have to have the P5 library here. You could refer to it from somewhere else. But for the sake of today, just so we could get through this video, the way that the IDE, and this is how the IDE works, so it makes the most sense to just look at it this way. Your project is your code It's the HTML file, which refers to your code, and then also the P5 library, which allows you to write all those functions like rect, ellipse, fill, stroke, that sort of thing in your code. And also, by the way, the index.html file is going to refer to that file too. So you've got to get all these things up on the server. Then you've got to know, you know, what's your URL? Well, presumably you have a host, you register for an account with some company, and they've given you lots of information, and you know what your URL is. It's, you know, blah blah.com, and depending on what the, if you make this into a directory, then maybe it's going to be something something. So I guess when I show you on the computer, if you're still watching, this will become more into more detail. But so how do you get this stuff to a server? There's lots of ways to do that. All sorts of interesting, strange ways. I have a personal, I really like using this thing called GitHub Pages, but I'm not going to do that in this video, and I probably shouldn't have mentioned that. We'll edit that out later, because I'm not going to edit that out later, because I don't edit these. But so you need to do something called FTP, and this is where I'm very excited to say that I think I know what that stands for. Mostly a file transfer protocol, because we want to transfer these files, and we need some protocol for transferring those files. And in fact, most likely what you actually need is SFTP. It depends on what kind of host or server or whatever you have. Secure file transfer protocol, because you don't want anyone to hack in and see your precious pink and purple rainbow colored shapes that you're uploading to a server. Okay, so this is the picture of it. I went on for too long about that. Now by the way, I haven't tried this yet. So now we're gonna go over to the computer and actually walk through the steps and look at how to do this. I'm gonna go over here now, see if this works. My computer went to sleep. Come back, there we go, okay. What do you need now? So you need some software, there you are. You need some, you're a camera. I guess you're a person at some point, but need some software. The software that I am using is, I'm gonna like zoom in on this, it's called CyberDuck. This is FTP software. It allows you to FTP files, but you know, Google FTP software, find your personal favorite, ask your friend who loves to FTP on the weekends or whatever. You might as well get CyberDuck. It's free and it works. And I also have the P5 IDE. If you don't know where to get the P5 IDE, you want to go to the P5JS website. That's p5js.org. And you want to go to download, and then you want to scroll down and you want to download the editor. The Mac version or the Windows version, which is really exciting because like a month ago that didn't exist. So I've already done that, so I don't need to do that. And hello, so I'm just gonna launch CyberDuck, and you're gonna see here, the thing that I need to do is I would like to open a connection. I need to open a connection to my server. I don't know, I made that full screen. I don't wanna do that, view, shoot. Get out of that. There we go. Open a connection. And now there's some information here. First thing I want to do is I want to change this to SFTP. And then wouldn't it be nice if I knew the server address? This is something you're going to have to know. I should like just pause this video, but I can't. There's nothing I could do. I had this set before. Schiffman dot... imnyuad.com. So that's like, what's the chance that that's right? D Schiffman, my password, very secret. I'm not going to say what it is. What's the chance that this works? Oh, I'm a genius. Okay, so I was really lucky. So, sorry about that, but I somehow remembered that. That's really lucky. Okay, so this is my URL. This is a bit of a strange URL. Most likely, you're going to have something. And I'm this host, the web host, I don't want to like plug anything here, but the web host I'm using is DreamHost. This is an account that's actually set up through NYU. It's a long story. But you most likely have something like, you know, funkywebsite.com or whatever your URL is. So you're not going to have this strange subdomain thing. But it's up to you. Whatever you've registered with your host, that's what you're going to do. And then your host is going to have different setups. There's you know, a bunch of, once you do this, you're going to see a bunch of directories. This is the directory of files that actually are publicly viewable on the web. So your server is sitting there, and you can have all sorts of files on the server, but there's usually a directory. Some directory, sometimes it's called like public HTML. There's usually a directory that's specified for whatever you put in there. Those are the files that you can actually see by making these requests. Okay, so am I back here? I am. So okay, so we've logged in. That's good. I'm going to leave that over there. I'm going to open up P5. I'm going to make a sketch. I'm going to say create, oh boy. I need to do something about making the font bigger, but I'll just zoom in for now. I'm going to say create canvas 400, 300, or that's my favorite canvas resolution. What's yours? Actually, I don't know. I'm going to say background 0, and I'm going to say fill 0, 100, 255, and I'm going to say ellipse 200, 150, 100, 100. That's my favorite kind of ellipse. I'm going to hit save. This is very important. I'm going to hit save. Now, where do I save? Wherever I save this, that's where these files, all these extra files are actually going to end up. So I'm going to save it to the desktop. I'm going to call it Schiffman Week 1, referring to my name, and it's week 1 of my semester. This may not be your scenario. I don't know if anyone else is going to watch this besides the people who are required to figure out how to upload their homework for the class. But okay, so I'm going to hit save. I didn't even test my code. I should test my code. I'm going to hit run. We can see that it works. I have my beautiful circle. It's blue. I don't know if that's my favorite color, but it works for today. And now I'm going to hit save again. And then I'm going to look at this directory right here. This directory, if I look in that directory, whoa, where'd that go? I've got those files I'm talking about. I've got sketch.js, which is my code. I've got index.html, which is that HTML file. You could look inside it and see what's in there and make changes to it if you wanted to play around. And then you can see here are the libraries. P5.js is the only one I'm actually using, but included also is P5 Sound, which allows you to play sounds and do all sorts of amazing sound stuff. P5 DOM, which allows you to do some other interesting things that have to do with the DOM, but you know, I got to stop this video at some point. So now what I'm going to do, really I should just start it here. I'm going to take this whole folder. Edit on the disk. I don't know. Maybe if you want to. Something weird happened. I don't care. I'm going to take this whole folder and I'm going to upload it. And I'm going to click allow. And if we look, we can see there that folder is in there, Schiffman Week 1, either some other stuff from like some other thing I did at one point a few months ago. But now, if you think about it, where is my URL? schiffman.imnyuad.com/schiffman_week1. Okay, let's try this. Okay, dun, dun, dun. I'm gonna go to schiffman.imnyuad.com/schiffman_week1. Oh, that worked. Oh, I'm very excited. See, look, and now all you have to do is, I don't know, put this on your Twitter or your Facebook or your email to your friends, or honestly, just go and edit that GitHub wiki that's for class and link it to your homework. So, this is a thrilling day for me that I recorded this video and that there's a circle here. I doubt this is at all a thrilling day for you, but I will see you again at some point in another video. Maybe, maybe not. I have to stop this now. Oh, I don't have a mouse. I can't stop it. Come on, mouse. Okay, bye.